1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to our channel. And things are great right now. I'm moving up in the world. John Fix even got me my own sticker. How cool is this?
As part of the jumble today, I need to give a little shout out to Scout Crafter. How many tips has he given us? Oh, tons of them. Well, anyway, I followed his advice. I've been using Johnson's Paste Wax, and he really recommended this Mother's California Gold Carnauba Cleaner Wax because it cleans and polishes. And I tell you, it does a fantastic job. I am really happy with this product. I did notice there is a difference. I took some tools that I had used the Johnson's Paste Wax on and redid them with this, and there is a difference in the shine. A little bit more of a haze with the Johnson's, not real noticeable, but there is more. But with this one, the shine was a lot brighter, and I think it's because it's a cleaner and a wax. And also, he's always saying, "Well, that smells so good." Actually, this one is pink, and it's really got a strawberry smell to it. I think I know the smell he's talking about on his. He said he'd gotten that wax, can of wax, from his father, so it must be quite old. And I just seem to remember a scent, a wax scent that was different than this. But this everyday, up-to-date one I just bought seems to be the same product and work the same, but it does have a strawberry smell. Thanks, John, for the recommendation. Another item I worked on recently, I've had in my collection for quite a while, and I didn't have before pictures of, with this great Crowder pliers, model 1831-8, which are 8-inch. Just beautiful, and that's why I like old tools. I mean, they took time, they were craftsmen. You know, look at the handles on here. You wouldn't see that nowadays. And inside each handle it says Crowder USA. On the other side it says Crowder USA, but embossed in there clearly. I mean, that's in there as part of the tool to stay. But I got to looking at some of the recent tools that Scout Crafter and other people have done, and they just were beautiful, and I decided I need a beautiful pair too. So I took mine, sanded them down, created that high shine to them, finished them off with that California Gold paste wax I just showed you, and these really shine. They just look absolutely beautiful. The jaws are in great shape. Everything is super on here. But now they look just outstanding. I had no idea these could look so good. Now I can see why everybody loves them so much. Here is an interesting pair of vice grip type pliers. These were called Gripso, G-R-I-P, Gripso, made by H.R. Bassford in San Francisco, California. This was patented around in the 1940s, and a little different design on it compared to normal vice grips. It's got the adjustment knob in the center here and a release lever here. Actually, I really like these for a couple of reasons. Let's compare them to a regular vice grips. Here's an old pair that I'm ashamed to say is in my toolbox, but I've been using for years. It could use a a John Fix cleanup, that's for sure. But the thing about vice grip pliers is, first of all, it's two-handed if you need to do any adjusting when you're putting it onto a bolt or a nut, and you have to hold with this hand and reach back here and do any adjustments back here. So it takes two hands to do that. These pliers are interesting. If you need to do some adjustments on it while you're using it, you can release it. You can do your adjustments here and then put it back on. So you can do it all one-handed. And if you're having to hold something with one hand and use these with the other hand, that works fine. I find whenever you're working on any kind of project, you need three hands, but you definitely need two. But when you're using two hands to adjust this wrench, you don't have that extra one you need. The second thing I like about it is, compared to the regular vice grip, when you tighten them up and close them, you have to reach in and push against your lever back here to release it. And it's just a little awkward, especially if you're using some gloves and that's a little tight in there. You can do it, but I think it's a little awkward with this one. What I like about it is your release is you just pull this lever and it releases. You're able to just, and it's, everything's one-handed, and I like the pull on the lever rather than reaching in and pushing against it. I've got another pair which are called Toggle Lock, model number 950. Let's see who that's made by. It's a channel lock. I'm sorry, it's a channel lock version. But on this one, again, it's the adjustment knob is back here. But if you have it clamped onto something to release it, you just reach up and grab this lever. The problem is, if you're working on something and you actually bump that, it releases. And you can bump it against some other work or in a tight spot, or just when you're gripping the pliers, if you mistakenly grip more rather than just on the handle, you reach out and catch that tab too, you've released them. It's an easy release, but I think it's a little bit too easy and it's sort of in the way. Just my opinion on these. So I do like this style. It never carried over. You never saw it anymore on any others. I really like the adjustment knob being here. The finish itself, there's some rust and corrosion on here. And it was done in a black oxide finish. I tried a little experiment and did a little finish work on here with the steel wool to see how clean I could get it. And first thing I'm going to do before I do anything more to the wrench is go over the whole thing with a fine steel wool to see if I can keep that black finish on here, which was the original, and remove all this tarnish and rust and patina on here. If not, I'm going to take the finish down, clean it really good, and try to do a refinish on it with the super glue, because I do want to try to keep it on the original color. So I'll get to work on that to see what I can do with these. Well, my mission on these Gripso locking pliers was to keep the finish as original as possible. And I went over it first with the steel wool, but there was a lot of rust and some really rough spots on here corrosion on here that I couldn't get off with that. So I went ahead and cleaned it down with a wire brush and then did a little sanding on it to get those rough spots off. And then cleaned it real well and actually used the super glue on here. And I think the super glue gave me really what I was looking for. It gave me a black finish, but with some luster, not the black oxide flat finish. Tool looks really nice. Looks very original. I'm sure this is how it looked on the original basis. Unless it was the black oxide, then it was sort of a flat black, rougher finish. And It works well now. It's cleaned up. I like the way that this tool works, the one-handed operation. Very pleased with the tool. In fact, I may just use this tool. I'm not too sure what I'm going to do, but I like it better than any of the vice grips that I have. So I'll call this one a success. The finish looks good with the super blue on here. And it works great. So there's the Grip Sole Pliers finished up, ready to go.